guy thinks his gas valve is broken.
You want to bet?
Oh. You know, Daniel would love to be here.
That is amazing.
How many do you have? What do you do? You breed snakes?
I do.
Do you really?
It's a little bit of a hobby.
And what do? They just chill there all day? He's a big mother effer, by the way. Oh, shit. Get out of here, bro. Get out of here.
And I come home to a tag on my door.
From National Grid?
They shut the gas off on the block or something.
Yes.
Someone came back and tried to, you see the little sticks, tried to relight the pilot. I'm not an HVAC guy, so I don't really know, but I'm an electrician by trade.
Okay.
So what I did was, I've lit the pilot before. I thought, all right, maybe the thermocouple's bad, maybe it's the gas tube. I replaced the whole entire gas assembly. The tube assembly.
What do you mean by assembly?
The
silver tube?
The silver tube, the copper tube, and the thing it actually mounts to the burner tube.
Pilot assembly.
Pilot assembly, that's what it's called.
You changed all those.
I changed it all.
So you changed the pilot burner tubing, you changed the thermocouple.
Yep.
And the only thing you haven't changed is basically the gas valve, probably.
Yeah, and that's one thing I don't think
so. You tell me, that's a new thermocouple?
Yeah, this is brand new.
Okay.
This is brand new.
So what's the problem? Won't light?
Still won't light. I can't even get gas to it.
You make sure the gas valve's on?
Sure. It's on.
Okay. See, that's pretty...
bad?
Well, the leak, yes.
I didn't realize it was dripping, though.
Oh, yeah. And it's dripping on top of your water heater. But this is actually pretty badass. Because this absorbs pressure. It's called the Aqua Cushion. And it's now equipped with a bleeder for relieving water logging, which may eventually occur. So this little bad boy here is supposed to absorb pressure. So when you close like a faucet real fast, you don't have that water hammer.
Right.
So this is like a primitive way of doing that instead of installing like an expansion tank.
I got you.
But yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I got no gas.
Oh, wait. Wah, 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 wah. All right, the knob on the gas valve, set the pilot, the red plunger, you push down on that, and...
No gas.
No gas? Okay, so, let's grab our handy dandy. Oh, there it is. Take off the... There you go.
It's enough. This doesn't fit.
It'll fit. There you go. Oh, okay, you so got gas there.
The problem's here.
Yes, correct.
You know what, I should just take the whole assembly out.
Yes, you should. There you go. Flip around the flare wrench, the 5/16 and 3/8. Wrong side. There's a link in the description box down below. You can buy one on Amazon, and I'll get paid 60 cents if you buy one. Thank you very much. We make sure the power's off to this thing.
Now it is.
I need a light. Is that?
You need a light? I am the light.
Flathead?
What's a flathead?
For the pilot assembly. Take it all off.
Take the burners out.
Want this?
No, we got.
This floor hurts.
Yeah, the floor does hurt. That's why God invented knee pads. We're going to take all those burners out. And we're going to see why we have no gas flowing through the pilot tubing and the pilot burner. All right, cleaned up pilot tubing, thermocouple, and we have pilot. Hopefully that stays on.
Right button, I couldn't get anything to even light.
Right, yeah. Same thing happened for me.
Let's see what happens. Okay. Pilot is lit.
Nice, solid blue flame.
Let's reinstall the burners.
Okay.
Let's turn this to on. And let's turn the power on. And let's bypass thermostats. No one's taken this out before, ever. There that is. Let's take off this. If it lets me. Of course, it won't let me. So now, if we take the two blacks together, which goes to TT, let's see. Here we go. Thermostat relay clicked, and we have ignition. That was the first stage. Wait for second stage to open. There it is. We used the shop vac, cleaned out the bottom of the combustion chamber, and lubricated and cleaned all the burners. Good to go. Approximately 6 inches off the top of the boiler, drill a small little hole, enough where it's going to fit that probe. A little more. There you go. Okay, is it on?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Now, the rule of thumb, because now this is a different boiler that I've been working on earlier today, is that that probe needs to be inserted halfway through the diameter of that. So I'll stick it all the way in, pull out a little bit more. That's a 6-inch diameter pipe. You want to be 3 inches off that back wall.
I think.
Okay.
That's all the way in.
Yep. There you go. Okay. And we want to see a similar stack. Well, similar readings than the steam boilers we were looking at earlier.
Right.
But our stack temperature will be lower, more than likely. We should not be.
We're right now at 324.
Yeah, you'll be in the mid threes. Our O2 will be similar. Our CO, our carbon monoxide will be similar. Our percentage will be somewhere around 80-81%, because this is an 80% efficient boiler. Where the sticker is, oh, no, is it on here? Nope. And our CO2 will be around there, 7-8%. Funny little smell coming from the boiler, right? It really hasn't, I don't think it's been on yet at all, or maybe there's some dust and dirt and some things in between the cast iron sections of it that are burning off. It's not a brand new boiler, it's from the 90s, so we may be in the 400, high threes, low 400 stack temperature. But it's still okay. But you know, if we saw something in high fives, sixes, you know, it's burning up.
Yeah,
and like I said, you know, good luck selling, you know, the homeowner a new boiler if it works, right? But when it's not going to burn down, but it's just very, 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 very wasteful.
Yeah.
All right, I would clipboard that and then do.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we just finished up Jose's first day working for Pipe Doctor, experienced technician, new to residential, but. We're going to give him 2 more days with me, 2 days with Daniel, and on Monday, we've got to throw him to the wolves. Just throw him right in that brand new Sprinter I got sitting outside the shop. And time to serve more customers with prompt, dependable, professional, and courteous service. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.